intermission, my son.
These enemies will revenge for taking the world of San Francisco, until my power of Triforce is mine, just like we accept it.
Great, keep doing that and remember, your revenge are to become evil of devil monster in the underworld, and the Phantasmic my villain is return, is mine.
Magic mirror, come from the farthest space. Through wind and darkness, I summon thee. Speak! Let me see thy face.
Famed is thy beauty, Majesty. But hold, three lovelier maids I see. And here, in Mickey's imagination, beauty, and love will always survive.
No! A magic spell in the black of night with a scream of fright. And a bolt of light. Turn my hair to white. Into a nightmare phantasmic! Imagine this!
I can't believe that Tilly just exploded with rocks and there's no way out, I am so sad.
It's okay, bud, we are sad too, because Tilly took my bow of arrow and she shot by rock and explosive and fall down into rock with no way out, it's all my fault.
And this is all my fault too.
Yes, bud, we all fault, because what we done. Joy and sadness, can we apologize Tilly?
Yes, Pumpkin, we gonna apologize Tilly, you are ready for journey?
Yes, let's go, come on Carice, let's go find Tilly. Let's onward begins.
Tilly, we are here.
We're here, Tilly.
I'm right here, Joy and Sadness and Pumpkin, I'm here.
Thank you.
Tilly, we gonna apologize for you.
And me too.
I'm sorry for we getting angry to you, and we leave a cave, because we left you alone while you sat and cry, you are my best friends.
I'm sorry for getting angry to you, because I get cry and him get cry too, because we left you alone inside the cave with your emotional, you are my best friends.
Thank you Joy and Sadness and Pumpkin, that is good apology about what happened, and you are my best friends you too.
Tilly and Pumpkin, that's Fantasmic is about to start with Mickey Mouse.
You are about to find out, for we now invite you to join Mickey, and experience Fantasmic, a journey beyond your wildest imagination.
Ha 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 ha. I can't wait get my claw and the boys and girls of Hero. I gonna kill them.
No one's touched the boy and the girl too, until get my girl. You hear me, boys?
First, I'm gonna find a two-person hero. I'm gonna wipe like Wicked and destroy them.
Knock it off. I'm sick.
At last, until is dead, I'm going to do my revenge.
I told you to knock it off.
Save your energy. This is boy and girl stolen my girl. And whatever that's reason, we gonna fight those two-person hero are wearing elf and princess. Before we attack us, I gonna have to throw you.
Here's the Flash Troublemaker. Will destroy joy and sadness and pumpkin, your majesty.
Well done, keep doing that. And today is my revenge for my son Ganondorf, the King of Thieves. And my nightmare Fantasmic is mine. Ha 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 ha. It's so cold outside. You guys good apology and for some reason can dream catcher like you joy and sadness and pumpkin. Don't want to be dream nightmare before pumpkin the angel princess will save the earth around the world. And this is called like I am I'm queen of fire.
Wow. That's awesome Tilly. Love this story queen of fire or maybe could be queen of ice. Or it will be enchanted fantasy become a hero and princess.
And stay from Hyrule Field and Princess Zelda's castle. Hero of time.
I must maintain the seal that Hylian rather, that I created so long ago and keep it strong for as long as I am able.
Joy and sadness, your spirit remained in the sacred realm and then the Triforce fell into Ganondorf's hands. He went on to invade the sacred realm. We must stop him to still Triforce us, right guys?
I agreed, that's a good idea, but how can we fight?
We must use weapon with my Hylian shield and master sword.
And we must use with my bow with 15 arrows, for once and for all. Now let's look up at the portal Hyrule world.
For generations, Hyruleans have told the tale of the war across the ages. This is how it begins. Deep in the forests, far from mortal eyes, a great sorceress watched over the balance of the Triforce. Through her magic, she could see across ages, able to read the fates of all who lived, but never interfering. That is, until a unique soul caught her attention. The soul of the hero of legend, eternally reborn when Hyrule's need is greatest. Through her powers, the sorceress should have seen that the hero was bound to another. Instead, she saw only a soul that was unlike any she had known. And while the sorceress was preoccupied, a fragment of darkness, locked in its prison, saw an opportunity. The whispering darkness wormed its way into her heart. It pushed the light away and warped her curiosity into a desperate desire to possess the legendary hero's soul. Of course, this evil had its own desires. To use the Triforce to resurrect itself and conquer Hyrule once again. Having pushed the light from her heart, the darkness compelled her to open the Gate of Souls, the doorway of time itself. Monsters from across the ages pour through the gate, bringing ruin to the land of Hyrule once more. Link left her village, vowing to restore peace to Hyrule. In her hand, she clutched her grandmother's precious compass. But before long, a mischievous imp had stolen the treasured possession. Linkle chased down the imp and tried to retrieve the compass. And then, something strange happened. As if in response to her struggle, the compass began emitting a mysterious light. It seemed to be reacting to her. Linkle recovered it, hung it from her neck, and vowed never to lose it again. The compass's light was quite a mystery to her. She didn't know what secret power it might hold. Whatever the case, it had to be a sign of her status as the legendary hero. If she could harness this power, perhaps she would fully realize her destiny and save Hyrule. Her faith renewed, Linkle continued her quest. Midna and Linkle made it to the Palace of Twilight to rescue Zelda and stop the evil magic. Yet though the battle was won, the Twilight magic continued devouring everything around it. It was then that Midna made a bold decision. She would smash the crystal they had found in the palace. In doing so, perhaps she could release enough energy to contain the dark magic. This plan was not without its consequences, as Midna would return to her cursed self. Despite the cost, Midna decided without hesitation, knowing that she must save Zelda. Midna's resolve deeply inspired Linkle. With renewed fire, Linkle hurried to Hyrule Castle. In the new world, Link met the pirate leader, Tetra, and they fought valiantly together as allies. But it would seem their enemies were stronger and craftier than they had imagined. After claiming victory, Link looked into the sky to see a monstrous bird flying off into the distance. Squinting to get a better view, he saw that the giant bird was carrying something in its talons. Not something, someone. It was Tetra. Link had to do something, or she would be lost forever. He dashed off to save her without a second thought. Lana and Link managed to rescue Tetra and close every Gate of Souls. But the change that had overtaken Hyrule seemed irreversible. Lana, Link, and Tetra were all at a loss as to how to remedy the situation. Just then, when they were most in need of help, a certain legendary figure appeared before them. He was King Daphnis Nohanson Hyrule, the King of Red Lions himself. In Tetra's world, King Daphnis was the ruler of the ancient kingdom that had been sealed away. By divine command, he revealed himself, hoping to save a world rocked by strife. He explained that the cause of the conflict was an evil presence in Tetra's world. Their target much clearer, the heroes knew where they had to go. They set out on their next journey, dreading the difficult battle ahead.